axis here and a y axis on this side. So there are 4096 green dots. We have 4096 green dots here. That's our data set. If we would represent these 4096 data values into our memory, then we would have required 4096 is equal to 2 to the power 12. So we would have required 12 bits per data value. So 12 bits per each green dot we would have needed to store it in memory. So let's see how can we use data vector quantization to reduce this from 12 bits to some number of bits. So these blue lines is after using vector quantization. Here basically what has happened is, based on the density, the regions are made. So it's like there are many green dots here, so within a small region all these green dots within this region are represented by this red color dot. All these green dots within this region are represented by this red color dot, and this region is very big but it has very less number of green color dots. So it's basically the region are formed based on density. More the density, smaller the region, and nearer are the points to the one which they are represented by. So all these 4096 green dots are represented by these 16 red dots. So in using vector quantization, 4096 green dots are represented by 16 green dots. 16 is nothing but 2 to the power 4. So we just require 4 bits to store 4096 green dots using vector quantization. So we need to know few terminologies. First thing we need to know is Euclidean space. So it's Euclidean space. In this example, I just wanted to show how in a 2D space vector quantization can reduce the number of bits required to store data. Of course, this is also lossy in the point that this point may have some data value and it is represented by this dot which is far from it, but it's the way you can save memory for large quantity of data. So first terminology that we need to know is Euclidean space. Here the entire space is a Euclidean space in this figure. So second one is Voronoi region. So each region that's within the blue area, blue borders, is called a Voronoi region. The entire thing is a Euclidean space. Each region is a Voronoi region, and each red dot is a code vector. So each red dot is a code vector, and all these 16 code vectors form a code word. It's like I have 16 red dots, so I will store them like each first red dot may have value like 4000, second red dot may have 2000, so it's like then has 502. So there are 16, it's like 0 to 15. So this becomes a code word. So these are each red dots. So third one we need to know is code word. I'll give an example for all these. And the fifth one we need to know is index in the vector quantized data. So for example, if I had numbers from 1000 to 10,000, and from these few numbers were the 4096 green dots. It may be some random numbers, it may be 500, 1000, 2001, 2010, 2500. So each of these values may be one the green dots. So the red dot may be the nearest value to them. Maybe 2500 is represented by 2000. So it's like 2000 represents 2500, 3000 and all those big region. So this is a code vector, and the bits used to represent these red dots, it's like this may be represented by 0000 because we need 4 bits. This red dot may be represented by 0001, this red dot may be represented by 0010, and this is called the indices. I just wanted to give an overview of what did we, how does vector quantization work. So I've copied a picture and I'm going to paste it now. So it's like we have a raw data, large volume data, and we have a vector quantization encoder which encodes. It's basically the regions, blue regions that we were seeing. So it's basically it's something like this. Let's consider this is one of part of the diagram which I showed in the 2D space. So the red dot is this one, the code vector. So after encoding or compressing the data, each red dot is written here. This may have a real value of 4000. So 4000 is written here. And the index is the value, it's like 0000 binary bits, so it's 0. So all the 4096 bits were represented by 16 red dots, and these 16 is like 0 to 15. So index is 0, 1 till 15, and this is the real value of red dot. So basically after compression we get code vectors, indices, and this is the code book. And using this code book and indices we decompress the data and get the data back. That's basically in the volume rendering part. I hope the vector quantization concept is clear, because we just basically want to know what's vector quantization is. A lossy data compression technique, and we know what does lossy means. That's the data is not as it was originally, and data compression is because it saves the memory, and it's a nice technique to save memory and have large data in space.